This my honey. Oh, wait. This ain't my white honey. This my honey water, y'all. I'm addicted to it. Whoever told me about this, I love you. I love you.
I can't feel myself. I don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my shining star.
Came into this situation to basically exonerate myself and be right. That's not my goal anymore. My goal now is to choose to be a better person. A better daughter. A better sister. A better friend. Dad, I'm so sorry. Will you forgive me?
Grandma, I forgive you.
Mama.
I forgive you, baby.
Please forgive me.
I do.
Tony, I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry, too. If I've done anything, I'm sure I've done things. Sometimes you forget people, you remember people hurt you, but you forget you hurt them, too. And I'm sorry.
Forgive me for blaming you for how everybody else treats me. I did that. That was not you. Those were my own actions. And the things that I've said and the things that I've done. So don't allow me to ever do that ever again.
Okay.
Please forgive me.
Absolutely.
Tracy.
Breathe, Miss Tamar. You're not breathing. Remember your breath? You gotta breathe. Because I want you to be able to do this and take care of yourself.
Forgive me for not showing you compassion and sympathy when you really needed it. And for real being the shoulder for you to cry on, the person for you to lean on, not half-assed, but wholeheartedly. I'm so sorry because I know that you need it.
Forgive me for not being there for you. Not knowing you was hurting about this. Forgive me.
I forgive you. And I love you so much. And I'm proud of you. For you, please forgive me.
I forgive you. I forgive you. All slate is clean with me, with you.
Hey, here you go. I confess.
I confess it. I can't handle this kind of stuff.
Well, you're gonna do a new thing today. Face your sister.
Please forgive me. We're not supporting you. And not sticking by your dreams and aspirations. You've helped me with everything. And I forgive you for messing up my eyelashes today. That wasn't perfect.
Now, the main thing that I want to talk about is the apologies. Okay? When I tell you last night touched me so bad that I started crying. And it was mostly Tamar's part that I was getting the most success. I mean, the most emotional from. And I think it was because I really and truly wanted to feel like Tamar was actually being honest this time. Because I'm sure that's not the first time that Tamar has apologized to people in her family. And Tawanda pointed out that I've heard Tamar apologize before, you know, but never with this much sincerity and never in front of everybody. I come to find out that Tamar blamed Tawanda for how the family treats her. Now, I don't know how the hell that happens, but you see, part of the Braxton family values is what goes on in this house stays in this house. And I really hope that that's not something that people still do. Because, you know, black families have done that for years. And guess what? What you hide secrets, good and bad. So that's why I believe a lot of sexual misconduct goes on amongst families that have that value. Because, you know, you just be taught what goes on in this house stays in this house. If your mama getting, you know, trashed or beat up on or, you know, mistreated, then you don't go to school and you don't talk about it. You know, if you getting, you know, touched inappropriately, you don't go to your aunt's house and talk about it. You don't do that. You keep everything in the house. Sometimes, you know, black families, we show our strength. We really do. And a lot of our strength comes from us being able to survive and maintain our family at all costs, you know, and but it sacrifices our children. Honey, oh wait, this ain't my wife, honey, this is my honey water, y'all. I'm addicted to it. Whoever told me about this, I love you. So to help with my allergies, baby, I had no idea, and I thank you. But but I was confused because I was like, Tamar, what happened? Did your fairy godmother come out and say to you, Tamar, you must apologize and show your true emotions when you come back in the car? I'm like, girl, that was just a bit strange, but I appreciate her coming back and apologizing to her sisters and her mom and her dad. What I won't like is the fact that your ass was just pulling a stunt. If this is the case, because I told y'all in the other video, I really do believe that Mama Evelyn was like, you're fucking with our money. Tamar, everybody hates you. They don't want to buy your music because of your bad behavior. People hate you, girl. You making everybody...
Tried to rap, Tamar did, and called her her real name Rhonda. And said she's the devil.
Well, in my experience, you know, I just didn't think that, you know, her tactic or the way she usually goes about things, you know, worked for my family. You know, I thought that, you know, this is not a situation where we needed to, you know, go back and fix things. We just needed to talk about things, you know, and it was just a little too abrasive and a little bit too much, and it was uncalled for.
And I heard that Tony, I was reading, that Tony was upset with you for walking out.
No, she wasn't.
Okay.
No, she wasn't.
Did anybody follow you in walk out?
Now, see, this is not a typical Tamar meltdown walkout situation, you know, and, you know, I've been battling myself on whether or not I want to say really what happened or not, because, you know, everybody wants you to be political.
Say it.
I'm Tamar and I'm real, right? You know, a lot of things
happen. Not anymore.
A lot of things happened
to
me. We'll talk. Right, right.
Go ahead.
In my childhood that I was, like, too afraid to talk about or too ashamed to talk about. Mm-hmm. But the truth of the matter is that, you know, I have been molested, you know, by both sides of my family. And it's not nothing I ever talked about. And I never thought that I would sit around a table with Ayana, who's here to talk about, you know, me and my sisters and their problems, and to bring that up and sex shame me basically in front of everybody. So that's why I got up and walked out.
Well, just as I thought, trash.
Supposed to be paying, you supposed to be buying pussy. Nah, you gotta make a profit. You gotta invest.
Nah, you talking about your credit score. Well, nigga, let me get a car in your name.